Thank you. this moment, I would like to introduce you to Father Peter Rookey, a Servite priest. He was ordained in 1941 at Our Lady of Sorrows Basilica in Chicago. In 1948, Father and six other Servites founded the College of Our Lady of Bedford in Northern Ireland. News spread rapidly of the healings and blessings and gifts received there. In 1953, Father was elected to the office of Assistant General of the Servite Order, which placed him in Rome. Father serves at Our Lady of Sorrows since September of 1985. He ministers far and near, over the telephone, through letters, and in person. His healing and compassion ministry brings him invitations to several parts of the United States. He has been on the cover of Extension magazine and in many news articles, witnessing to God's power through prayer. He is the author of The Shepherd of Souls. Father Peter has been honored by the Pope, who designated him a Knight of the Holy Sepulchre. The cross that Father uses when he blesses contains many relics of Servite saints. Father will individually bless each one of you this evening with his cross. So let us welcome Father to the microphone.
I feel kind of fenced in behind a podium, so I kind of walk around here a little bit if I may. I'm a little bit nervous, and this is my first time in public. And besides, I'm just a rookie, so. The first time in public here at the Chateau, so this is something new for me. Reminds me of early days in Ireland when they used to come to be blessed in the bus roads there, and there were so many, we had to have it outside. And that's years ago. I was just thinking as Kelly was talking there about the two Irish ladies talking about Ireland. You know, St. Patrick's Day is coming up on the 17th, so everybody's getting ready for that. But these two Irish ladies went to a funeral, and the priest eulogized the deceased so highly. Mary said to her friend, "Sure, we must be at the wrong funeral. I didn't know this man." So I thought I was at the wrong place tonight after that big buildup. I made some notes here so I wouldn't forget. Did everybody enjoy the movie on Medjugorje? Several times, and have experienced terrific miracles there. And those miracles have followed us back to the United States. But just a couple of hours ago, I did just what you saw in that movie. I looked up to the sun with my naked eyes, saw the sun coming to me, dancing, making this beautiful aroma of all the colors of the rainbow. And then the two rays come down right into you. It's a very shaking experience. And I've witnessed it so many times. But even back here in big, bad Chicago. And I I'm reading this text without glasses. Of course, that's another miracle. The Lord healed me of blindness when I was a young lad.
Thank you. is, our healing is a whole healing, or it's not a healing at all. And so we ask the Lord to completely heal us.
Awesome, this is Magdalene of God. Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Jesus, come with us to Gethsemane, and God is to never have a break of death. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
and he said, my soul is sorrowful to the point of death. Wait here and keep away from you. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, and
and now down in praise. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
Father, if you are willing to take this cup away from me, nevertheless, let your will be done, not mine. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
angel appeared to him, coming from heaven to give him strength. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
and
pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Would you give a picture with me or Dan or Dick or somebody?
I'll take you.
Okay.
You probably go ahead.
Hi. It's already going. I get his aim at it.
Huh?
So,
all right, move in, Dick. Towards. All right, now. Good. All right?
Love you. You love the Mother of God. You do too.
Okay, good. Thank you. Just walk past me and I'll give you the
camera. How long do you want to before you start? Do you want to go back?
Be back here in 20 minutes.
20. Okay.
Oh,
question anything that you would like to ask. Yes, she's feeling now better.
Oh,
thank God.
Do have them.
She says that you might have a problem.
Yes, I have a problem.
No, no problem. Yes, she has visions every evening.
Every evening?
Sometimes at home.
She feels
better, much better now.
Yeah. Can you ask her if Our Lady's face looks like the statue in the church?
Because it's not from this place, that's all people.
She has
great dress. White apron. The crown from the stars. Blue eyes. Black hair. And the cheeks are a little bit red. And she's saying in the clouds above the ground.
Red cheeks.
Father Eric, get up. Bonjour. Father Eric and Chris want to come up closer. Father Eric.
Okay, she's suggesting to pray.
Listen.
She's suggesting to pray our Father and Mary together.
Mother Paul!
She's going to
pray for us.
Kako na nebu, tako i na zemlji. Kruh nas svagdani, daj nam danas i otpusti nama duge naše. Kako i mi opuštamo dužnicima našim i ne uved nas u napast, nego izbavi nas u zlamen. Zdravo, Marije, puna gospodinica, blagoslovljena si među ženama, blagoslovljen plod utrobe tvoje Isus. Sveta Marijo, Majko Božja, molim za nas grešnike, sada i na čas smrti naše. Amen. Slava Otcu i Sinu i Duhu Svetom, kako bijaše na početku, tako je sada i vas za vijeke vijekova. Amen. Kraljice mira, molim za nas.
I'll give you my card if you can get a good singer.
Is it working out, Chris?
Yeah.
I don't want to plug the picture.
I don't want a picture. I want a kiss.
This is none with the kiss. This is the none.
This is a nun.
I was a sister kissing you. I can all about it. I love you.
Thank you.
the pun of his own name, actually, come they will be down on earth, that's his term.
La visita della Madonna. Maria ha tira così in Elisabeth Gesù, la visitazione. Maria è poco di la sua radice Elisabetta.
Oggi nasco e si ne vede.
Thank you.
I blagoslovljen plod utrobe Tvoje, Isus. Zdravo Mario, milosti puna, Gospodin s tobom, blagoslovljena si među ženama i blagoslovljen plod utrobe Tvoje, Isus. Zdravo Mario, milosti puna, Gospodin s tobom, blagoslovljena si među ženama i blagoslovljen plod utrobe Tvoje, Isus. Slava Otcu i Sinu i Duhu Svetom. O moj Isuse,
Permettere, ci prego i colpini, misteri dolorosi, preghiamo per la pace, il misteri doloroso, preghiamo per la fede, agonia, più detto in piedi trite, niente al volto sui, giorno al testo, amore mosamine, chi si sono noi i trovati in noi?
Oče naš koji jesi na nebesima, sveti se ime Tvoje, dođi kraljevstvo Tvoje, budi volja Tvoja, kako na nebu, tako i na zemlji.
Please don't photograph. You run silent, other people know. No photograph.
Kraljevstvo Tvoje, budi volja Tvoja, kako na nebu, tako i na zemlji. Kruh naš svagdan i daj nam danas, i otpusti nama duge naše, kako i mi otpuštamo dužnicima našim. I ne uvedi nas u napad, nego izbavi nas od slame. Slava Otcu i Sinu i Duhu Svetom. Kako bijaše na početku, tako i sada i vas prihvate Izraela, slugu svoga, kako veća ocima našim, spomenite se dobrote svoje prema Abrahamu i potomstvu njegovu do vijeka. Slava Otcu i Sinu i Duhu Svetom, kako bijaše na početku, tako i sada i vazda i u vijeke vijekova. Amen.
but...
What the heck's going on?
I can't see the sun, man. Back again to the far side of the Jordan to stay in a district
where John had been once baptizing. Many people who came to him there said, John gave no signs, but all he said about this man was true. And many of them believed in him. And this is the gospel of the Lord.
Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And treating it. And many years ago, Archbishop Sheen had a conference on the idea, why is there so much hatred in the Holy Land? And his thought was that it's precisely because this was the point on planet Earth where the Word became incarnate, that hell is infuriated. Overtime, double shifts, to stir up hatred where there's such a potential for good. Huh? And then using that as an analogy for ourselves. If you are not, the devil's got you in his bag, so to speak. Any problems in life. But the fact that you have a great potential, all of us have a great potential for good. Now, as we leave this place, this holy place here, this holy land, I would think that we can all expect problems. Just as you have problems, get it? We were under attack, so to speak. Patience was attacked, where fortitude was attacked. And many of us recognize that in this transcendent dimension. And I would guess that, you know, as we go forth and to tell others about this holy land, it will have obstacles. So expect them. Don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. The devil's greatest victory is to make us discouraged. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which Eric was given and human hands have made, to become for us the bread of life. Let the mystery of this water and wine, we have come to share in the divinity of Christ, to humble himself, to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, made by human hands, that have become for us the blood of Christ. Lord God, we ask you to receive us. Be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from my sins. Pray that our sacrifice, prayers, and our daily living, symbolized by this bread and wine, may be pleasing and acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord
My mom, my kids, my Barbara, everybody.
Thanks, Bob.
Okay.
He has all of the authority of Rome behind him. And it's very interesting if you look at these two people, Pilate and our Lord. Pilate with all the apparent authority, and Jesus standing there in chains. What's really interesting, I think, to note is that Pilate, the one thing that he wants to do at this moment is to free Jesus. That's the one desire he has in the face of the earth at this moment. And you will see Pilate with tremendous strength trying to do that. He's negotiating with the high priest, he's negotiating with people, he's even negotiating with Jesus trying to free Jesus. The one thing Jesus wants to do is the will of his Father. Would to God there was anything but crucifixion, but the one thing Jesus wants to do is his Father's will. Isn't it interesting that Pilate, with all of the apparent authority and all of the power, and he speaks about that to Jesus, he says, you know, I have power to have you killed or to have you freed. With all of his authority, Pilate is not able to do the one thing he wants to do, which is to free Jesus. He winds up crucifying him. One thing that he wants to do, which is the Father's will.
The glory of Christ be praised because of the Holy Cross. At the second station, Jesus takes up the cross. And I think, first of all, in this station, we might just think about the cross in our life. And traditionally, we use the cross as the symbol of the difficulties in our life, the problems and the difficulties. It's really interesting to me, though, that the cross takes a number of forms. For instance, the cross is physical difficulties that we all have at times, sickness, this kind of thing. The cross is moral difficulties, just the difficulty that we have trying to live the moral life of following Jesus. But another interesting thing to sometimes think about is how, in our life, our gifts are crosses. If you have a gift, that gift can be a cross. For instance, you know, if you take a ministry in a church, say as a Eucharistic minister or a lector, you know, you have to contend with the people who may not appreciate you being up there. I really learned about the station myself. I was absolutely fascinated. I've never been to the Holy Land myself. I'd like to go one day. But in hearing a priest who has been to the Holy Land, what I've come to know is that, and some of those of you who have been to the Holy Land would understand what I mean, is that when you make the station to the cross, you want to do so. Christians tend to be really affronted by the fact that when you're living in the streets of Jerusalem, walk the Via Dolorosa that Jesus walked, we are really affronted by all the crowds there in the marketplace. And this is really what you find it in the heart of everything from souvenirs to film to making stations to the cross. And remember, when Jesus carried his cross to Calvary, it was at the time of Passover. The place was just chock full of people, just huge crowds. And what's also important to know is that you and I tend to think of the crucifixion a certain way because of television, for instance. When I think of... Thank you.
beautiful little space here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know what kind of fish is a
pink
almost?
Yeah, yeah. Very beautiful. Mm-hmm. Fourth station, Jesus meets the sorrowful and afflicted mother. We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you. Because Jesus meets his mother Mary and looks into the face of his mother. And it's really interesting because when he looks into the face of his mother, it's not like when he looked into the face of someone like Pilate, for instance, or even the apostles, or just unbelievable. And I think all of us have probably realized in life that it's really a lot easier to suffer myself than to see people that I love suffer. It really seems to be.
Woman who comes up out of the crowd and wipes the face of Jesus on the way to Calvary. Now this station, although it's many boys might say a legend and a mystery, has a real significance related to us. And it had a particular meaning for the people, the Christians of the time of the Renaissance. All these tremendous works of art we still enjoy today. But the danger for the artist is that after having seen the tremendous masterpiece, the artist begins to think of himself through the intervening profound in the lives of people in terms of particularly the planet. So frankly, the humor and so the church wanted us to know this, and because of it, the church pushed as far as it wanted to move the church. For instance, if you were, let's say, Michelangelo, and you just completed the 16th chapter, the tremendous masterpiece, and you walk by the shrine of the Lord, and you are reminded that the greatest painter in the world has not happened to true image of Jesus. It's the saint. It's the saint who's done it. It's the person who, in her life, or in his life, lives Jesus, who has captured the true image of Jesus. And that's why meditation is this station. Now, you and I don't have to worry about being so artistic, say, Michelangelo, and you have
oh, you don't have it.
putting us at our worst. We're tired of it. You're going to be sorry when you see the thing.
Yeah.
Just breathe.
So Jesus falls the first time. And I think you remember there I said that we should think about the people who still maybe have caused us to fall in our lives. But now, what I'd like to humbly suggest to is to think about the people in your life that perhaps you allowed to fall, and to ask God to forgive us for those times. I can think of my own life, for instance, of a lot of times when through my indifference, again, it's the indifference that oftentimes causes the fall, through my indifference, by not caring enough about people who are really hurting and needing my helping hand, fell for lack of my hand. And just think about that for a few minutes right now, and to ask God to continue to forgive us for those things, and to ask Him to help those people.
If you notice I'm breathing heavy and hard, it's because the air's getting thinner up here. But oh God, it's wonderful to be here. Now that I take off a few pounds next time I'm here, maybe I won't be so out of breath. Praise you. Father, Lord in heaven, be thy name. Thy kingdom come. I won't be done. Father, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Chris, going from the sublime to the ridiculous.
Another one.
Another saving.
I saved a lost soul.
12th station.